Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
Okay. We had to set the ambiance early, obviously. Yep. We have the flannel, the brown shirt. I think I'm colorblind. I'm not sure, but
brown,
it feels
gray. It's doing the thing.
It's doing the thing.
It's doing the thing.
Is it green? What is it?
I actually don't know. Me and Kaylin had a huge argument about like what color it was.
Really?
Yeah.
Man, I would never get into an argument about a color because
I'm exaggerating a bunch.
Oh.
she's like, it's purple. I was like, it's not purple. It's definitely more brown and gray. She's like, I see
she
purple.
She said it's purple?
She said she saw a purple tint. You're colorblind. You don't have a say in this.
Just me going, I would never get into an argument about a color and be about to get into it.
You're like, wait a minute. Yeah.
Anyway.
First time digging into Paul Simon. We made a community post the other day.
Well, Simon and Garfunkel.
Simon and Garfunkel.
Don't forget Garfunkel.
Dude, you're so right. I just feel crappy now.
Yeah,
we made a community post where we were like, who is your favorite songwriter? And a lot of people said Paul Simon.
Yeah.
And I had not really even heard of it at all. You mentioned you've heard a couple things.
Yeah. I've heard two songs. I've heard 50 Ways to Leave Your Lover, which I think is an amazing song. And then You Can Call Me Al, maybe, I think.
And that's his solo work. So we read a little bit about it on Spotify. And apparently him and Garfunkel were like the best, like the most successful like folk rock duo, like songwriters of the 60s. So very cool thing before he launched his solo career, which is also very successful.
Yeah.
So very excited to get into it, man.
And also, like I said, we're setting the mood with the dress. We're getting ready. It's almost Christmas time. I hope you're spending it with your families. Or if you don't see your families, at least you're here with us. We're your A&A family.
Good holiday cheer.
Spreading that good A&A Freedom Shack. Now it's the Freedom Christmas Shack holiday cheer. With that being said, let's get into it.
Yeah, man.
I am just a poor boy, though my story is seldom told. I have squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jest, still the man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. No more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of the railway station, when I'm scared. Laying low, seeking out the poorer quarters where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know. La la la, la la la, la la la, la la la. Asking only workmen's wages, I come looking for a job, but I get no offers. Just to come home from the wars on 7th Avenue. I do declare there were times when I was so lonesome, I took some comfort there. La 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 la. Then I'm laying out my winter clothes and wishing I was gone, going home, where the New York City winters are bleeding. And a fighter by his trade, and he carries the reminders of every glove that laid him down or cut him till he cried out in his anger and his shame. I am leaving, I am leaving, but the fighter still remains. Lie, 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 lie,
was beautiful.
That was incredible. I have goosebumps, which happens frequently when we listen to great music, but wow.
Yeah.
Let's get a moment of silence, guys. Collect ourselves. For those of you who have heard it a million times, it's our first time, obviously. So, okay. For sure, we're going to dive in the lyrics. We'll do that in a little bit. The onset, he tell like just some of his word choice when he talks about the railway, like working or living by the railway, or he talks about he remembers every glove that grazed or cut his face and the shame it brought him, like just like all these so visceral feel, like such visceral feelings,
yeah,
and told in a great way. It's really evocative to me of when we listen to Janis Joplin, and she had the song where she mentions the windshield wipers, me and Bobby McGee. She mentions the windshield wipers keeping time with her playing in the truck.
Yeah.
And it's like, wow, that was such a moment.
Detail, it paints it for you.
Yeah, it's a moment that not everybody would think to write down, but it's something that everybody, once you say it, you go, oh, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. And to me, this whole song felt like that. And I got to be honest, the production quality and level of production styling in this is, when did this come out?
60s.
That's insane. This is production that I promise you, as somebody who listens to like modern music, is in the vein of what is happening now with modern music.
Mm-hmm.
And you have these like folky elements where it's just like some guitar work, mm-hmm. and it is really over like reverbed snare,
yep.
and then all these like side percussive pieces.
I had never really experienced just having like a kick like just in the right.
Yeah,
I don't think there's one kick in the left.
It's and a then, super then, modern production technique. Like that's something that people nowadays will use.
And then you have the horn on the left.
Yeah, or whatever. I don't know what it was, but it was something cool.
Some kind of horn. It was some kind of like, you know, brass instrument for sure.
Yeah.
I never experienced it. That was just it was a really cool thing. There are a lot of things in this song that I just like, it was like almost like a first time for me, like beyond just, you know, Simon and Garfunkel, but just like production-y things like that.
Yeah.
Where it's like, I never really experienced that before.
This is, again, this is cutting edge even today, and I can't stress that enough.
His voice, dude, oh my goodness.
Beautiful.
Completely melts into the chords and all the changes. And you even noted it towards like probably the two-thirds mark of the song, just the chord change just felt so smooth, so nice.
Yeah, he had like some different, it felt like everything was, he is somebody who has got to know music on an incredibly deep level, because it made it feel effortless, and it
feels so natural.
It felt natural. It felt like he was, every individual chord he was utilizing to its full potential.
Mm-hmm.
I can't say enough praise about this. This is wonderful. This is wonderful.
Yeah, very excited just to dive deeper into them.
Let's do the lyrics real fast, and then we'll...
Lyrics have been read, and magnificent, man. Just like poetry.
Yeah, and some of the lines that stuck out to me a lot were when he talks about he was like looking for a job, like, mm-hmm. and he's like,
just like a workman's wage, nothing crazy,
just workman's wage, I'm willing to work for it, and send him out. The only offers he gets are from the whores on 7th Avenue, and he was like,
and sometimes, you know, like,
I was so lonely I did it.
That's insane, dude.
And I don't know if he's just painting this picture or he's trying to tell some like grander theme, or probably both, but if I had to figure out like some theme or something that was, it felt like to me, it felt like the boxer, right? The reference to the boxer, he has all these scars that are his reminder and basically what he's taken from all the battles he's fought in, all the times he's felt shame, all of that. And every time he's talking about, I'm going to go home. And the narrator, when he's talking about, you know, I wish I was away from here, away from these New York winters that are bleeding me dry, like I want to be away from this. And then at first I thought it was just la 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 la, but it's not, it's lie. He's saying lie la lie 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 la lie 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 la lie. And it's like, man, it's just a lie. Like, I'm gonna leave this place. La la lie 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 la. It's lying. You're lying to yourself. You're not.
And it also feels like it's beyond himself and even like that own character, but more so just like about, like, let's say the common man of the times and the struggles that they were facing then, you know?
Yeah.
And it's just like very thought provoking. Very great song, dude. Very great song.
Yeah.
What is the rating? We've been gushing for a minute.
I'm gonna give it an A+. This is a song that is very on the cusp of like A+ or S.
Yeah.
I want to hear more of Simon and Garfunkel, because I feel like there's more depth to it, but I mean, really, there's nothing wrong with this is a perfect song to me.
I feel the exact same way. Excited to dig into them.
Yeah,
dude.
Awesome.
Because very prolific songwriter from what everyone's saying, and just like how many songs he has with Garfunkel, as well as, you know, just on his solo career, and just crazy, very crazy.
Yeah. With that being said, gosh, this was a really, really good, like, going into Christmas. Thank you guys so much for being here with us. Like I said, if you're with your family, have that, appreciate them. You know, not everybody has that, and for those that don't, if these videos make you feel better,
we're your family.
Yeah, we're your family. If these make you feel better, that's all we could ever ask. We get messages all the time on Instagram talking about how much you guys appreciate us, me or Andy, and we, you know, it's not our intention to do that. It's just a brilliant byproduct of that. So,
for sure.
Thank you for being here. If you want to chat with us on Instagram, we're there. Andy and Alex Official. Link in the description. Send us a message. If you aren't around anybody for the holidays, send us a message. We'll talk with you. We'll be a part of your family. Message. There's a great community on there. We'll do a Christmas post, and we'll talk to you guys there. But with that being
Absolutely.
Said,
see you Friday.
That was great.